Greetings, my biceps. Are you okay down there?
I just start making excited angel noises. Hello, internet! We're here. We're doing the thing. No, stop. Stop moving. What are you doing?
I'm just checking the volume setting.
Oh.
I'm just checking to make sure that the volume is coming through. It should be working, I think.
Let me check on the...
No, I know the voice volume's coming through. I can see it. Just the desktop audio and video capture is kind of quiet, but it might just be because we're in the menu.
Yeah.
We'll address it if we want. For now,
yeah. I mean, when you had the Advanced Wars thing open, it was kind of quiet. Like, I could barely hear the music that was playing.
That's fair, so... Let's begin Tears of the Kingdom.
Oh my god. Here we go. See what on earth is happening. Nintendo presents.
Now audio is showing up. Okay, so we're good. We're good. The Legend of Zelda. Interrupting phone.
That was good timing, though.
Okay, like usual, it starts right in the game.
Here we go. Oh, they're going. Look at them go.
This strange gloom keeps getting thicker. We've been descending for a while now. These tunnels are deeper than I thought. What could be down here?
Zelda, Princess of Hyrule. Just in case you weren't sure. Oh look, I have max hearts!
Wow, look at you go!
Oh god, Link is about to lose everything.
Oh no, this is gonna be so bad.
There's no way that they gave us max hearts and the Master Sword to start, and they're not going to immediately take everything over. Focus, move, press to crouch, action, put away, jump. Hammer controls.
Just imagine what Zelda's thinking right now watching you do that.
She's thinking, ah yes, my hero.
People have been falling ill after coming into contact with the gloom drifting through these caverns.
Oh no.
Though here it seems almost misty and not concentrated enough to harm us.
Oh dear.
We'll keep going. With it coming up from beneath Hyrule Castle.
Uh-oh. And Hyrule Castle's already enough of a ruin, because that's where Ganon was hiding for like 100 years.
We do not know what waits below, so we need to be ready for anything. But I know I'll be okay with you, Link.
Aww.
Let's go solve this mystery.
Yeah. Am I gonna lose the Master Sword?
Probably.
Yeah.
I mean, it makes story sense for you to have it.
Because this takes place after Breath of the Wild. And
like, recently after Breath of the Wild.
Yep, and Link has apparently put all of his points into health rather than stamina, because in Breath of the Wild, you can only have either max heart or max stamina or max of neither. I don't think it's possible to have a max of everything. Okay, oh no, he has max stamina and max hearts. He must have found a few extra heart containers lying around after the events of Breath of the Wild.
Or he spent some time, you know, buffing up.
Yeah.
They probably have had a little bit of time.
Yes?
Yeah, oh. Ooh.
Master Sword.
Oh, it's glowing!
Uh-oh.
Oh, dear.
In Breath of the Wild, it only did that when you were fighting off against Ganon-possessed guardians, or were in Hyrule Castle, or a few other select locations.
Okay.
So, So that means that there's definitely something down here that's a problem. Mm-hmm. Since the castle, ever since the end of Calamity Castle's fondest neglect, I never could have imagined anything like these tunnels were hiding here. I don't think anyone could. We must be careful as we move deeper. Agreed.
Shiny. Splashing at the tunnels like a...
What was it? What button? No. There we go. This is normally how you throw weapons, but I can't remember the exact combination. There we go. Oh, I somehow did it. From the Zonia.
Ooh.
I don't know what the Zonia are.
Maybe the mist isn't so problematic for them right now because he has the Master Sword.
Yeah. Oh, she's taking pictures with the Sheikah Slate. Zonia in origin. I've seen designs like this in my studies. Zonia are said to have lived long ago in a time of the earliest legend. They possessed godlike powers and had a prosperous civilization in the sky.
Ooh.
Many history books tell us about the Zonia, but none give the full picture. Much is still unknown about them.
I wonder if that's references to Skyward Sword.
Maybe. And it's so late in the timeline that they've become called the Zonia.
Skylofty and Zoni don't seem like they'd be all that.
This is what the Zonia looked like. It seems so different than us. And such large ears. How did the ruins from a civilization in the sky end up beneath the castle? It looks like a path ahead goes deeper. Let's continue. That is a good question now.
Well, I mean, Skyloft was carved from the kingdom below. The Skyloftians probably had... Maybe the Zona even predate the Skyloftians.
Yep. Hey, look. I'm crouching.
I'm not freaked out yet. But it's good to know that you can crouch if we get to that point.
Yeah. Oh. Certain must all be from the Zonia civilization. Agreed. Mm-hmm. Oh, bats!
Oh, here we go.
You're not hurt, are you, Link?
Nah, aww, just tiny little bats.
That's adorable.
Well, she would be concerned. I don't have a shield at the moment, that's so.
Fair. Look at these murals.
It looks like Calamity?
Yeah.
The written histories of the royal family.
Oh, cool.
Include stories of a great war fought long ago. It was a conflict between allied tribes and someone only ever referred to as the Demon King.
Ganon or Demise? Because we already fought the Calamity, which is supposed to be Ganon, but...
Is it possible? Do these murals depict the same legend?
Looks like the Zonia were there as well.
This is similar to the statues we saw earlier. A Zonai.
Oh, a Zonai.
Yeah. And these figures look like Hylians.
Oh, that's cool.
This depiction certainly suggests that the Zonai descended from the heavens.
Well, at least that's what was believed at the time.
Yeah.
It's said that my ancestors, the first of Hyrule's royal family, were born from a union with gods who had descended from the heavens.
Huh.
Well, she is...
These murals tell a similar story. Yeah. And if they are accurate, then the gods mentioned were the Zonai. They must have forged a relationship with the Hylians of that time, working together to establish the Kingdom of Hyrule.
Okay.
That's so cool.
This figure, he seems to be stealing something of incredible power from the young kingdom.
That has to be Ganondorf.
No, it... It might be Demise stealing the power from the Zelda of the past, who was highly reborn.
Shows the Demon King.
Or it could be Ganondorf. It's hard to tell.
It looks a little bit like him. Something about the facial hair, the look on his face.
Yeah.
If the creature depicted here really does represent the Demon King, then...
Yeah, look at the goblins.
Yeah, and the mane behind it. Yes, I play on a Nintendo console, Dragon Primal.
Oh, hi, Dragon!
This mural must be the Great War recorded in the Royal Histories.
Great War many years ago, which led to them developing
this
the Guardians.
The imprisoning war, and the events that led up to it.
Imprisoning war.
This is a huge discovery.
Aww. And I'm going to just stand here silently. Here, let me hold that.
Oh, that's so sweet.
All right, then. Now to use this invention of Pura's. I'm glad I didn't leave it behind.
Oh, that's what you were doing. You were using it beforehand.
It's so easy to record.
Oh, it's not the Sheikah Slate. Oh my god, it's a Nintendo Switch for the camera. It
looks like the rest of the murals are obscured.
Uh-oh.
Oh, dear.
That's going to be important later, I just know it.
Just what is this place?
Well, it mentioned the imprisoning war, and the trailer did show that, figure imprisoned possibly down below the castle, so... Also, that fog over there looks red, so I have a feeling I'm going to need to use this to get through.
Danger, danger. Yeah, this kind of reminds me of what the Master Sword just going through the floor.
Yes.
It kind of reminds me of the fog that would kind of seep out from the spike where the, imprisoned was.
Yeah.
You know, that same deep, dark energy.
Yeah. Looks like it definitely doesn't like light. Though it's hard to tell if it's from me. No, it is from me, because... Oh, maybe it isn't? It's hard to tell.
Yeah.
But it definitely is a problem.
She's
like,
what
is this?
I mean, you are below the castle.
And
it would make sense that you'd... Oh, God. Okay, this feels problematic now.
Yeah, I thought I heard, weird, noises.
Yeah, give me that, too. It's gathering around you.
Yeah, it's getting thicker as we move down. Is implying that whatever's down here is the cause of it.
Mm-hmm. And it seems much more... Oh my gosh, it looks like it was turning into hands to try and grab you.
Well, there was in one of the trailers it apparently overtaking a rat and supposedly killing it. So I do think that it might be more than... Oh, this is from the trailers. Something's down there, and something is definitely leaking out. What is this place? I don't know, Zelda, but I want to.
Let's be extremely careful. Okay.
What is that?
Looks like a glowing hand of some sort holding the corpse. Almost as if it's, sealing it away.
Oh, it fell. Oh, no.
Oh? That looks like a little tear thing from one of those, on the mural, the little, tear things that were showed.
Well.
Maybe this is a tear of the kingdom.
Roll credits. Oh, my God. He looks like Ganondorf. Oh. The red hair is
moving back.
Oh, my God.
I saw that coming.
Oh no! Okay, alright.
Oh! I knew it! Not even the Master Sword can fight this thing. Oh my god, the Master Sword.
There you go. Oh no! Oh.
Hey.
Was that the sword that seals the darkness? The blade that shatters so easily against my power? Cannot save you from me.
Your face is... The Master Sword actually broke! Huh? You know me?
Raru placed his faith in you.
Raru.
And that was all you could do.
Yeah.
How do you know our names?
They don't know about the timeline. And this must have been one of the Ganons from Ocarina of Time then, if he...
Oh no.
The castle's about to start flying! We had enough problems with the castle in the last game. Miss Ganon remembers the past Link and Zelda.
It do look so good.
Yeah. Oh, he's falling down into the darkness.
Oh no! Come on, baby.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Oh, the tear in her hand. It's... I think it just teleported her.
Oh god, I hope so.
What the...
Who's got him?
Oh! Mr. Glowy Hand?
Hi, thank you.
So the hand that was sealing it away saved me? Or sealing him away? Oh! There's stuff falling from the sky! But the castle is rising up and it's not falling from the castle. Where is it coming from? Oh god.
The moon.
No, we do not need a moon with a giant nose. We have enough problems.
It doesn't need to have a giant nose. You could have a giant eye socket. I don't know.
We already have enough problems with the moon in Breath of the Wild when it turns red and all the monsters respawn.
Yeah, well, maybe we're going back to that. I don't know.
Not only did I lose all my health, but I literally broke the Master Sword.
Yeah. Oh. Is it...
It's on me, I think.
Is it healing him?
I don't know.
God, I hope so. Even if... It's not going to be able to restore your health, that much I know, but...
Yeah, well, that wouldn't be a game if it did, but...
Look at how...
Oh, it definitely... Even if it's not restoring it, it definitely... Something. Oh, look at the. It looks almost like runes now on his arm.
To protect, probably for protection.
Yeah.
Oh my god, look how long his hair is.
It was not that long previously, was it?
He had it back in a ponytail.
Okay, that's fair. Oh.
Oh my gosh.
Look at his fingers.
It's probably just trying to contain the curse.
Possibly.
Link. Ah. Finally, you wake.
Huh? My glove talks to me.
It's gonna be your fairy companion. He's on your arm.
Yeah.
I've heard a great deal about you from Zelda.
Well, thank you.
You've met Zelda?
Your wounds were severe. I am relieved to see you escape death.
Yep, I still got 3 hearts. I'm fine.
Your arm, however, was beyond saving. I had to replace it, lest the injury endanger you further.
Okay, oh, no. So I have a prosthetic arm completely.
All right. Thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, Mysterious Voice.
Are you the Great Deku Tree? I doubt it.
No, he doesn't sound like it because you do meet the Great Deku Tree here. But the sword is...
Oh no.
It was damaged in Breath of the Wild in like a past cutscene, but never this bad. It never actually shattered.
Oh my god.
Okay. Oh. The sword that sealed the darkness. Its sacred power has been diminished after being ravaged by the gloom beneath Hyrule Castle.
Yeah, that's not just damage. Yeah. That's decayed. Look at it.
Yeah.
It doesn't even look like it would properly cut through those things.
But it's the only way I have, so...
Yeah. I have to admit, when he first had... Okay, I guess it does work. When he first... Like, when the curse hit him, it... His arm looked like, and the way it was spreading looked like Ashitaka.
Look at that. Glowing portal, and looks like I'm in some sort of underground temple-ish area.
Yeah.
What's this? Is this like a fast travel site or something? Oh, that is a fast travel site back there, or at least it looks like the ones from the shrines in the previous game that let you warp around. Mm-hmm. So, also, what happened to all my clothes?
Well, they probably had to be cut off during the surgery that saved you, that replaced your arm.
Yeah.
The pants, I don't really know, but they may have been contaminated.
It's possible, because, you know, it mentions decaying Master Sword, so whatever that darkness is that attacked must have some sort of decaying power, which is why people were getting sick.
It looked like, honestly, the way his curse looked like, it looked like Ashitaka from Princess Mononoke. Yay!
Dash up the wall! Oh, or I could just climb. Oh, all my stamina's gone too.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeet. Still got great form. Yep. At least some things were preserved.
Let's go further underground. That's a good idea.
Oh my god!
Landing in water, even from great height, will prevent you from taking damage, even if it does make it rain a bit from the big sploosh.
Oh, that's fair.
Yep. Oh. Ooh, chest! Do I have pants? Oh, that's new.
Yeah, he doesn't.
I have pants!
Okay. Well, you're already doing better than, Archaic.
Oh.
Archaic. Oh, hello.
Simple, classic lit. Well, they are worn and showing their age, but they've still got a few good years in them.
It can be a bit cumbersome to have to tie the straps.
looks almost like a toga. But hey, at least I'm not walking around in my underwear.
It's honestly looks like it covers less than your underwear.
I am not underground.
Oh. Well, are you on the moon?
I'm in the sky!
You're in this...
Well, there is a giant spherical thing over there that kind of looks like a moon, so...
Oh, here, jump off of this flying... Ooh, look, there's that Death Mountain.
Yeah, I can see Death Mountain. I can see a Borg cube over there.
Oh, God, we're bringing in all the crossovers
here. Okay, so jumping isn't a bad idea, but... Whee!
Are you sure it's not a bad idea? This seems like a terrible idea.
Mm-hmm. You can see them flying around in the original game and even get parts from them, but seems like there's one up here now too. Whee! This must be, I don't even know where this is, but I can see a snowy over the area over there, so it's probably going to be the Tears of the Kingdom equivalent of the Great Plateau, where it kind of teaches you how to play and lets you explore around on your own.
Snowy.
Yeah. Link's foot is conveniently placed to block the shot up his skirt. Hold R to accelerate. Whee! Link the Lily Man.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
It kind of feels a little bit like the place in in some of the temples you see in Abzu.
Yeah.
Great Sky Island, yes.
Not to be confused with the Great Plateau. Oh look, a stick! Tree branch! Other branches such as these are pretty common, but surprisingly well balanced. Doesn't do much damage, but can serve as a weapon in a pinch. Use this to select and hold, press and hold, and then change weapons.
Oh, yeah, let's...
Well, yeah, the Decaying Master Sword is the weapon. What?
Oh, I thought it meant you got two tree branches.
No, that's just the attack power. Now I have two tree branches.
There you go. Cut down the tree.
Oh, look, mushrooms! Sky Shroom.
Needed to restore health.
Very little health, but still health.
Well,
apples!
You have very little health to begin with.
Apple!
Hi. Take out another tree branch.
Nope.
Is Zonai charge.
Material used as a power source for constructs and other devices. It has a strange light and seems to reveal potent energy inside. And soldier construct horn. Way like horn from a soldier construct. Very sharp, so I end up with care.
This would be so fascinating if you see the... because this would take place so... Like you said, this like Breath of the Wild would take place so far down the timeline that it doesn't really... matter so much anymore.
A wooden stick. Yeah.
It would be.
That is, I think, what Zelda. That is, I think, what Nintendo said, that it takes place really far down the timeline.
So it would be really, really cool to see it go, but like to see it revisit some of the roots from like Skyloft, which is the first in the timeline.
Yeah. Also, I did figure out how to throw things. I just need to hold until he like charges like that, and then just release. I don't actually need to push a button.
Not only that, but I don't really think many of the other games explored each other all that much.
No.
The closest I can think of is like you knew that Phantom Hourglass took place after Wind Waker. It kind of established the characters, but what happened in Wind Waker didn't really matter during...
Yeah, this is the first time that it's not only a direct sequel to... Or not the first time, but it's one of the first times that it's a direct sequel to a game. But more than that, Link apparently... Or Ganon apparently recognizes Rauru or remembers him. So... Oh, what is this thing? Is this thing going to try and kill me?
Well, that's not the first direct sequel. Whoa!
Hello? Hi.
Hello? Hello, sir.
Hello? Hello?
Aw, he's... Why is he
He's bleeping and blooping at me.
Why is he cute?
Link, I have waited for you.
It's a steward contract. Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Princess Zelda left something for you in my care.
Which Zelda are we talking about here?
Well, given how it's the magical camera...
Oh, yeah. This is
the Pura Pad. Not to be confused with the Sheikah Sight. I am told it is a valuable tool that will provide you with direction.
Oh, that's nice. I guess...
But that actually confirms that Zelda did get out somehow.
Yeah, she's okay.
Look at the Nintendo Switch.
It's Nintendo Switch.
Even more so than the iPad of the last game.
That is so funny.
Pura Pad, I don't know how to say her name.
Pura sounds right.
Princess Zelda's prized device. It has a variety of features that are essential for adventure.
And it also has the Sheikah Eye logo on it.
Adventure!
Open.
I received it from Princess Zelda. I have now passed it to you. My records indicate that Princess Zelda is waiting for you at the location on its map.
Oh, okay.
Master Chapter has been delivered. Where am I? We stand in the Garden of Time.
Oh. I just love that.
A Temple of Time is visible from here. Okay, so the big temple in the other game might not have been the Temple of Time, or maybe it was like based off of this Temple of Time.
Yeah.
It was used in the distant past. Many rites and ceremonies of the kingdom were held there. But no more. It is a lonely place. No one visits.
Yeah, because not a lot of people can get up to the sky.
Ooh.
Oh. It would certainly hinder travel prospects.
Yeah. Find Princess Zelda. Ooh.
Oh, look at that.
This is going to be an interesting place to explore, that is for sure. Oh, she took some pictures.
Oh, look, I think you're in one of the pictures.
Yeah. Adventure log. Okay, definitely going to be a few other points that I can see down there. Okay, let's move on.
Oh, the fast travel points here.
Maybe not. That one just looks sort of like maybe a switch.
That's cool. The way they slot together.
Yeah,
This is making me think a little bit of the...
Yep, no fast travel here, but yes, sorry.
Let me please finish my sentence.
Sorry.
The way they slot together, some of the technology makes me think a little bit of the Ooka.
Yeah, maybe.
And also what you were saying earlier, there have been several games that are considered direct sequels, but this is one that I think is going to be... But you're right, this is still different because it seems like the events of the first game will have more impact on the second game. And it's one of the first bye-bye. And it's one of the first... There's going to be somebody down there who gets a tree branch just falling from the sky, and they're going to be really confused.
You
know,
you seem to be new here. Do you intend to use that weapon against the soldier construct? Soldier constructs? Are those given strict orders to protect this land? As only you created us directed them to eliminate trespassers, they will consider you a trespasser. You must treat them as a serious threat. Allow me to offer unsolicited advice. It's crucial to maintain proper distance and target your opponents. Swinging haphazardly will not yield results. This is how you lock on. You may break the target on me if you wish. Oh, please do not actually attack.
Oh, yeah, please don't break this.
Yes, I am not going to attack this poor thing. I know someone out there on the stream definitely is going to, but if you want to see that, you can go watch that person's stream. Throw the weapon in your hand.
This is going to be very interesting to see how they address the different timelines and the past history, because they haven't.
Yeah, they really didn't in Breath of the Wild either. Whee! Oop, froggy. Oh, look, it's that frog that Zelda wants Link to eat at one point.
That's great. Well...
Hey, it was 100 years ago. It's fine.
Your lily pad is sinking. Send help.
Oh, I see a robot. Let's sneak up on it.
These do look... Yeah, what are these things called? They're called sky sentries?
I think so.
They look like the guardians from
Sneak Strike.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They look... Soldier constructs, yeah. They look, they kind of remind me of the, what you call it? The guardians from the trials in Skyward Sword. Obviously, I don't know how much of that is on purpose. It is. Hello? Hello?
Go back, I want your meat.
Ostrich?
Raw meat!
You can eat it raw, but cooking is better. But
yes.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
Also, just for healing properties, it heals you more if you actually cook it.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah. It's okay, guys, I already got some meat.
I also have a bunch of mushrooms and apples. I'm gonna make a delicious stew.
You actually can! Oh, let's see if I can get... Can I...
Oh, there's more mushrooms over there by the tree.
I don't think I can get up there.
Yeah, nope. Oh god. I was afraid you were going to just fall off the sky.
I'm fine.
Well, you don't have a sailcloth. That token of yours isn't going to do much to catch the wind.
Yeah. Actually, I probably don't have enough stamina for this. Let's get down to the stores first at least. I can try.
Nope.
Link is not quite Spider Link.
That's fair. He's had a bad day.
Yep.
He lost his arm. Oh my god.
Yeah. Okay, well, we'll explore around more later because I'm sure that there will be a time to. But for now, let's continue heading towards the,
Where is Zelda supposed to be? Ooh!
Yeah. Hold on.
Oh. There goes that rock is leaving without you. Catch! Strike! Actually, wait, no.
Oh, what did I do?
Like,
oh.
Are you taking a picture? No, this is not the time for a selfie.
Nope. Didn't even see that. They threw a rock at me because it didn't.
Well, it makes sense. It improvises just like you.
Yep.
Also, I guess since you took out one and then had to kill the others, I guess we can call this a spare.
Long stick! Yes. Yes, it is.
We'll have more bowling opportunities later.
Yes. Yes. For anyone who does not know, Fiance has not actually played Breath of the Wild yet. Alas, but I will convince her one day. Oh, look, cooked mushroom.
You don't have to convince
me. Oh, yeah, I don't need to convince you. Just Ah, I roasted that, but it is yours if you want them. You roast them? Oh, you hadn't noticed that before? You weren't unfamiliar to me? What?
I had not noticed before that you were unfamiliar to me. My apologies.
Among my tasks is to explain anything that visitors may require knowledge of. You may have questions about this place. Please rest assured that a construct can answer them. I recall your question about the roasting food. I roast ingredients by placing them beside the fire. I do not eat, but I'm given to understand that it improves the taste. Creators roasted ingredients in order to enhance their nutritional value. Do you have ingredients? I invite you to use the fire to roast them. Okay.
I will get there. It's one of those things where, like, it's not that I'm not interested in it. It's sometimes like getting over the hump and starting something that's so, like, different and so vast can be a little bit of a challenge for me to get started. I've found myself sometimes, especially going back, like when it comes to video games, I'm actually more likely to play something I'm a little bit more familiar with because it adds a kind of a level of relaxation to it, which I like, because usually when it comes to new things, there's usually a high amount of energy involved for me.
Yeah. Well, I will say Breath of the Wild does make it easy because it lets you, it restricts you to the Great Plateau at first.
Oh, yeah, shield!
I actually have a shield now! Yep, targeting shields! And I actually now have a sword! It's a bit rusty, but it'll work. Back to tree branches, though. Gotta use those first.
There's something great about watching Link just run around with this little toga skirt, an old shield, and a stick with leaves on it. I mean, this is great.
Huh? Something tells me I might not be able to get in here just yet. But I might be able to, I don't know.
I mean, this looks about the same as the others. Yep. No. Well, that's rude. Why you do this to me?
Yeah.
That door will open only to those with sufficient power.
Oh!
Hi!
I'm sorry. I did not intend to startle you.
It's been a bad day.
It was I that spoke to you earlier. That arm originally belonged to me.
Oh.
Thank you?
I am Raru.
Oh, maybe it's a different Raru?
Source of the right arm.
Different Raru? I'm so confused!
Either that or...
Forgive me for appearing to you in this manner. Unfortunately, I no longer have a physical form.
Oh.
Could this be the Raru from Ocarina of Time?
In any case, that arm should allow you to open this door. It seems to have lost the power to do so.
Well, that's rude.
Yeah.
You might be able to restore it, but you would need to enter a place filled with sacred light. Of course. Why not visit the shrines on this island?
Of course. You gotta always visit the shrines. It's Breath of the Wild. Ooh!
That's the same sacred energy that was securing
the shrines. Yes, I'm sure they are the key.
Yeah.
Whether it's Ganondorf or Demise or something.
Yeah. Oh! Yeah. Okay, bye. Okay, so I gotta find a way over there.
You know, that actually could be Robert from Ocarina of Time because he was actually an ancient sage. He's much older than the others.
Yeah. There we go. I placed a pin on the map so that way I don't get lost.
There's very little that's actually revealed about him in Ocarina of Time, but he introduces himself as an ancient sage, and he's obviously the one who's not seen outside the Temple of Time the way that the others are, because you have to awaken the other sages like Darunia and Eboru and Ruto and Saria and
I found an arrow.
Impa. So it is possible, and while he appears to be Hylian, We don't really know much about the Zonai right now. It's possible that they are... And those murals certainly tell a story, but sometimes murals tell a story and, like, tell history in a creative way because people did not fully understand how to, like, depict it or understand what the powers of certain creatures were.
Yeah.
So Zelda is interpreting them as gods, and the people who made the murals probably did as well. But it could be the relationship is much more complicated than that. Well, that looks like fun.
It looks like some sort of grind rail. I'm assuming I'll be able to get it later, but...
We're gonna have fun! Minecraft Zelda edition.
I wanted to climb down.
Well, you did. Just very fast.
Yeah, wanted to get some rush rooms. They increase speed. Hey, don't you throw rocks at me!
That Robin was a Hylian, and but when he continued his work in the temple, he didn't really, he kind of outgrew his physical body, and so the body that he shows to you is a, it's kind of a cultural, kind of a construct.
Mm.
And the closest he gets to appearing outside of the temple is through Gebora Gebora, the giant owl.
Yes, who everyone
has a wonderful time with.
Yes, even if the option is always set to no for some reason,
well,
rather than yes.
Because they're expecting it for new, because they designed him with new people, with new players in mind.
Yes. Oh. How does this become a shrine? Let's find out. Okay, there's a teleporter pad.
Very nice, very nice.
Oh, okay, that is cool. All
right, go.
That is much cooler than just like a random door opening.
Go inside the Tarthus rock. It's bigger on the inside. There we go. We got a highlight reel now.
Oh, it's like a teleporter. Place is definitely different in the shrines of the original.
Hey man, what's up?
Oh, yes, I have made it here. This is the Shrine of Light. Long ago, I filled these places with light that purges evil. Believe this light will restore an ability your right arm has lost. Mm-hmm. Now then, extend your hand.
Ah.
Oh, it's the, Sheikah Slay power up music. What do I get? Oh.
A key.
Bloop.
An unlocking symbol, I don't know. Ultra hand.
Grab and move objects, rotate them, and stick them to other objects.
Yes, you get to make your giant stick now.
Yes. Oh, this must be a replacement for Magnesis, which only used to work on metal objects. This is the ultra hand ability.
He got a quiver for some reason.
He had that. I picked up a bow. Notice that?
No, I didn't notice. That was... You didn't Boop. Say anything.
I thought you were paying attention.
I was...
It allows you to move objects freely and attach them to other objects. With this, you will be able to build a great number of things. Really, anything you can imagine. Hooray, it's Minecraft!
Yay!
Use Ultra Hand and receive the blessing from the shrine.
I didn't see any pop-ups on the screen.
That's there like was.
This is a bow. And you moved past... Oh, yeah, that's right. No? I'm looking at the wrong thing.
Okay. First off, how... Okay, sorry. I'm going to turn off motion controls.
Oh, yeah, I have to, Yeah, I've had to do that, too.
Nope.
Oh, great. Good job.
Oh, that's that. That's that. Oh, that's item. Oh!
No! Oh! Oh, cool. Ah!
Oh.
There you go. It's gonna bug me. Where did you pick up the bow? Was it just outside?
One of the enemies that I stealth striked, yes, they had
okay.
A bow.
Okay, I missed that.
No. Okay.
Good day. Thank you. Close to pop up really fast. I was talking about something else. Things happen. Ah!
Okay, that was not a correct attachment. How do I unattach?
Oh. The wiggle the arc. There you go.
Okay, so rotate. No. Okay, so let's.
Yeah, the... ah! Look, ultra glue.
It's but Mighty Putty.
Link just made the biggest seesaw ever. Look at that. There's something that's still in motion here.
Yeah.
Can you see that?
Yeah. I think it's demonstrating how this works.
Ah, you get to go for a ride! That was fascinating. And stick! My god, it is like my funny. That's so funny. There you go.
Mm.
You got this. You can do this. You're functioning highly and you can do this. Good. There you go. Alright. Hop on.
Go. Going for a ride! Woo!
This is the closest highlight, This is the closest Hyrule gets to having a roller coaster.
Yep. Oh, there's. Looks like there's someone in there. Sort of like the monks from.
She looks like Princess. She almost looks like Princess Zelda. Mm. You see that?
Yeah. You've done well to reach this place. We offer this light that will cleanse you of evil.
Thanks.
I need it. I kind of lost a lot of my
power. Actually, that could be why the hand has lost its power, is because Link was contaminated by so much of that evil darkness.
Yep. Rather than a spirit orb, I now have a golden orb.
Aww.
Oh, it's now inside my arm, and my arm is glowing with the power of light.
The power of light. Oh yeah. See.
Yeah.
You see that.
Light of blessing. Crystal of light that purges ancient evils and purifies with its radiance.
Nice. Ah, look!
Whoop. May the light of blessing grant you the strength you seek.
Wow.
Are you going to dissolve into light? Nope, you're just going to go back into your...
Yeah.
And then it automatically teleports me out because...
Shrines.
Yes, because shrines.
Safe skydiving. Landing in deep water will prevent taking damage.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's nighttime now. Yeah. Hi, buddy. How are you?
Very well to get through that shrine. You've restored an ability. It's just wonderful. If you visit and complete 2 more shrines, you should be able to open the door to the Temple of Time. Mm. You may want to mark shrines in the distance with pins, then you'll never lose track of where they are. The Pure Pad offers a very helpful scope. It's quite handy. Oh, I can see one.
Yeah. He actually talks a little bit like Rauru, kind of like the older, there's kind of like an older energy to his words, but he also too is like, kind of like, I think he kind of gets a little overshadowed by the fact that Rauru is a bit of an exposition guy when you meet him in person. And it also, and as Kapora Gamora, the owl, he was like incredibly chatty with his stuff that a bunch of new people fixed. But he's actually very nice.
Yes.
And very encouraging, which would mean a lot to a young child like that Link is.
Yeah.
The putty thing is just cracking me up. Yeah, it looks great.
Okay. Rather than going all the way back over to the rail, I'm going to do this.
Perfect.
Look at that. You didn't even need the fourth piece. It was literally just there for decoration.
Yep.
Look at what you did.
I wonder if there's any... I can't get over there now, too, but now I'll go later. We gotta head towards the shrine with my glue hand.
With your glue hand? That's great.
What? It makes magic glue. Now I just need to... I wonder if this will let me merge things with weapons, or if that still takes time. Oh, look, a boat.
Oh, hey, man.
Hello, Raru. See, they're still at work even now. We originally created the construct to assist in our endeavors. All of us were fond of them. Never imagined they would continue to carry out their assigned tasks to this day. Mm. The fact that their labor no longer serves any purpose at all, yet they perform it still. It is disquieting to me.
So he hasn't been around here very much.
Yeah. Good! Zodiac charge found in this old...
No longer have
it because
it's
a
flame. What is this?
Boop! Got an arrow. Arrow, governor.
You could basically remake a tree. That's great.
Yeah. Extra face forward. Face it head on. Pardon me. I was absorbed in wood cutting. Are you here for wood cutting too? Wood cutting? Wood cutting is the practice of chopping down trees to create logs. Logs can be combined to assemble platforms. You can also chop them down further to make wood. Number as many uses. This is why I come here daily to chop wood. I still find it difficult to chop them down to the intended direction. This is why you may have heard muttering myself, fix your gaze forward, face it head on. Ah, I apologize, I have been rambling for some time. There's an axe I no longer need over there. It is yours to use if you want to do some wood cutting. Oh my, has it grown that late already? I must have failed to notice the time bell. I will rest for today.
Yes, until Lord's 4:15 in the morning. Everybody take a nap.
Oh. No, this axe is glowing blue.
Ooh, fascinating.
Is it because maybe it is used as a tool, or is it something that I can actually mix with other things? Oh. And if I'm near the campfire, I can sit around for a while. I'll be okay. And yes, my axe did get set on fire. Yes, if you have wooden items.
Oh my god. Lord, I'm getting flashbacks to being like 12 years old. And that was my favorite thing to do whenever we had a fire pit. Because I didn't actually like roasted marshmallows for a long time. I would actually, like, whenever we were making s'mores, I would just use a raw marshmallow. I liked the taste of it. And also, too, it was the best way for me to eat them because I had braces.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it really wasn't something I should have eaten anyway, but the unroasted marshmallows seemed far less sticky. And they didn't really crumble off. I was like, oh, this is fine. They still taste good. So what I would do instead, aside from roasting marshmallows for family, it was really fun to do it for my mom because she liked them burned. Mm-hmm. So I would... So it was fun to set them on fire.
Sunset fireflies.
I would just literally take a stick and light the tip of it, and then walk around the backyard pretending to be the Statue of Liberty. Like, I shall light the way, and just my parents were just like, alright, just stay away from the trees and you're fine.
Yeah. Oh, I like how it actually shows the shadow so you can see if what you're making is long enough.
Yeah, that's
oh. Right. Oh,
there. Yes. Okay.
Alright.
I think you have to fit it into the grooves. Do you see how those grooves are? Perhaps if you do it, it won't roll so much.
Yolololol.
Then again, maybe you just have to find your
balance. Yeah. Oh, what is this? Oh, my own little movable platform.
Well, that's nice. Oh, cool. Takes a lot of guts to just jump onto this random moving platform that you just moved with your brand new shiny
magic arm
while you're up in the middle of the sky at 2:30 in the morning.
Yeah. Amber.
It takes a very specific type of bravery to do that. Granted, it's probably not the weirdest thing that Link has done today. But Lord. Excuse me.
Yeah.
That's pretty funny.
Let's catch some more fireflies, because you never know when you're going to need raw materials. There was actually a quest in the original where you had to, like, catch 10 of them for this girl. Because you wanted to see them.
Aw. Fireflies are pretty sweet.
Yeah.
Well, like, you catch them in your hand and you just, like, peek in and you see their little butts glow up.
Yeah. Oh. There is a suspicious rock over there.
No rocks could be that suspicious?
We'll see. Just give me a second. Okay, what's under here? I knew it!
Hi! You're at Hestu?
Really? I found 900 of you in the last game, if this is canon to that full 100% completion. More Korok poop. And yes, the seeds are confirmed poop, because Hestu gives you a giant one.
Ow! Don't do that!
I will do that. There's too many of you.
No!
I swear, if there are 900 of you again, I'm going to lose my mind. But I'm also not going to find all 900 of you, so... Yeah. Keep an eye out for weird rocks, multiple apple trees next to each other.
It's not his fault there's so many of them. He did not ask to be born. He did not ask for his siblings. Let him rest in peace. I'll drop rocks on him.
Shh, quiet. I am engaging in hunting. Hunting? Yes, I hunt wild creatures that I have in the forest. Never seen you here before. Your constructs reveal several roles. One is to provide any necessary explanations to newcomers that you other constructs meet will be able to answer your questions. You may have other. Dispatch wild creatures. Oh, yes, teaching me how to stealth.
Wonder if there even is the time bell anymore.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't seem like there's anybody to, like, bring it.
Yeah.
Ma. Smile! You're on candid camera! Actually, no, that's what I should say when you take pictures with the Kira plate.
Yeah. Smashing! Okay, you know, let's just do this. You're supposed to break, Mr. Box. There we go.
Your behavior is a threat.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to threaten you, Mr. Dude. Just trying to drop stuff.
I have to admit, that is perhaps one of the most polite warnings that you will get from a robot. It's like, warning, your behavior is a threat. If you continue, I may be forced. I may end up attacking.
Yeah.
Just FYI. That ostrich guy still looks freaked out by me. Look at him!
There's too many rocks around. I can't see anything.
You are there, having a time here.
Not worth it. Right, let's keep moving forward. I see Robert up there.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Raru, what's up? I love this view of the Temple of Time. I always took a moment to appreciate it whenever I passed here. The Garden of Time was quiet. The only sound heard was the time bell ringing in the mornings and evenings, as the whole place changed at its chime, especially at night when the sound signaled the emergence of fireflies. Mm. Those were glorious times.
Yeah.
Oh, so maybe going into the Temple of Time will fix the time bell, maybe.
Maybe.
And, oh, there's something down here. Hey, dude, cooking!
I was absorbed by preparing my next meal. Aww.
Cooking? Educate me. All the creatures in the room. Throw them over a pot in the fire. Cooking complete.
He's so...
Thank you. food take joke.
Aww. Okay, I think this one is my favorite.
Yeah.
This one is my favorite. He made a joke.
Restless crickets. Yes, he did. I like him.
Aww.
So let's see.
I mean, it's also kind of funny. Like, some of them are a little fascinating.
Yeet.
Because, like, the one that broke the ingredients and then this guy's cooking, because they specifically say that they can't eat. Some of them, like, for
speed up.
Nice. Some of them for, like, the guy who's chopping wood, for example, you can see how, that would be. Something that they, you know, they're fixing, you know, they're fixing the constructs to make platforms. You know, that's something that they themselves, yeah, even as constructs, can deal with.
Oh my god, they actually want to see the recipes now!
Ah, nice! But, the fact that they're so excited, like, he's so invested in cooking. Look at oh, he's so excited! I think he's so excited about cooking, even though he doesn't, even though he can't eat. It's surprisingly endearing.
Yeah.
Okay, yep. He's so excited. Like, looks like he also thinks that you can apparently just have him walk around with food.
Yes. You can have him walk around with anything from your inventory, just holding in his... in his hands.
Oh my gosh. I get so excited about this. This is basically the Zelda version of ground pounding. Bye.
Lots of arrows.
Robert is the same guy from Ocarina of Time, it actually could explain why he feels so connected to the Temple of Time. I mean, that was, seemed to be kind of his home. He's aside from being out, he's never seen outside of it, and it's never entirely clear if he, like, is normally the owl. Or if he, like, possesses the owl, or if he can transform, what?
There's a loud bell.
Ooh! Hi, bell.
See if I can climb this.
Yep.
Yes.
Cool. Makes sense. Look at all the grooves on it. Yeah. Can you move it while you're standing on it?
No.
Oh, that would be really cool. Basically, when Guardian loves you, so you're moving platform.
Okay, I see what I need to do.
Make yourself some stairs.
Yes. Don't know what's up here, but it might be something.
Nothing else, it would be a very nice view. Come on,
I can only move it up so high, but I can probably then move it more when I get on top of it.
This has been your climbing music. Thank you, everybody, and good night. Aren't you so happy you decided to invite me to join this?
Yeah. Okay, another bow. Another charge. There's not really as much up here as I thought there would be, but, you know.
It's pretty fascinating to see what those arrows, what the charges will do.
Yeah. Very nice.
It's beautiful up here.
Yep, and I'm getting closer to the shrine. Progress is being made.
You know, actually, with the... this place being in the sky, kind of lost to time. You know, some helpful robots, some war-like robots, still some wildlife, some flowers, some birds. Beautiful structures that are falling apart. Do you realize how much of this seems like Latita from Castle in the Sky? You can draw a lot of parallels there.
Yeah, fair point.
It's also still, too, it has the same kind of quiet beauty, although this one seems to be a little This one seems to be a little bit more... there seems to be more natural, like, nature around.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't even see you there, buddy.
Hey, man.
Hitting a weak point does double damage.
Enemy's head with an arrow, yeah.
Ooh. Rusty broadsword! I'm going to use the stick first, though. Rusty shield.
That these robots are still fulfilling their purposes, even though there's no way around to really serve. Oh, cool!
Oh, it's a chest that requires you to defeat the enemies to unlock.
Yep.
Okay, that seems familiar.
Definitely. That's definitely something that's used in a lot of Zelda games. I think a good number of dungeons have rooms where you can defeat enemies in order to proceed, or you can get additional items.
Yes, but there are a few in Breath of the Wild where you actually need to defeat them, because otherwise you can't just run up and grab the chest. The chest itself actually locks itself, so you can't get it.
That's fascinating.
What is that over there? That was a chest, but...
yeah, it's breathing. I need to reach my friend. Oh, what's wrong? Are you having a panic?
No, he's stuck on his back.
Oh, it's a Korok. Yeah. Huh? Hi, buddy.
Not a Korok, but I'm the judge in the forest. I was traveling with my friend. We got separated.
Are you Hestu?
No, Hestu is very big.
All
right. My friend is sending up a smoke signal. I can't wait to catch up. I'm so tired, though. I can't move.
You have this giant backpack. You're like a Goron merchant from Wind Waker. Can you pick him up?
Yes.
Oh my god, do you need to build a platform and take it for a ride?
Yes.
I think you do.
And I think I know what to do.
Oh, this is great.
That.
Look at him just rolling.
Yeah, actually, I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger.
Yeah.
Just in case.
Yeah, those are the same backpacks that the Goron merchant used in Wind Waker.
It's way too big for him.
It's way too big for him, yes!
I do like it.
Beautiful! Come on,
alright, so that I...
oh. You can attach him to it? You can attach him to it?
I wonder if I should do that, just...
yeah, let's do that to avoid him falling off. There you go. Hang on, buddy.
Yes.
There you go. Like a canoe.
Whee!
A sky canoe. Whee! Oh, careful there, buddy. Hang on.
Move.
There you go. I wonder if his brain also has a backpack on.
Yes, he does.
Oh, he is next to him. He did it last. Thanks. I have to give you something, but here's all I have. 2 Korok seeds. Okay, so that's actually a really nice way to mix up the whole find the Korok quest.
Yeah, their faces, they look exactly like the ones from Wind Waker.
Yeah.
I made it thanks to you. Aww. They're adorable.
Yes. You'll have plenty of chance to find them in Breath of the Wild.
Yes.
You know what? I bet I could actually also make a platform out of these boxes, but because I already have one that's made, let's do this. Boop!
There's...
I was supposed to break!
If that had hit you and caused damage, I would have left.
But that would have been a Breath of the Wild tradition, being honest.
I would have left.
Killing yourself with your own bombs or because you messed up one of your abilities is a Breath of the Wild tradition. Like, seriously.
Accidentally went swimming and lost all your stamina.
No. There was still stuff I could use to make another one, but I'm glad I don't have to worry about that.
I know, but just imagine. But no, I wasn't too worried about that. I was worried that you were going to fall off over open air.
I'm sure I'd be fine. Okay,
Why?
That one does have an enemy.
Why do you think you'd be fine? You'd be falling from the absolute sky in a much higher dive than what you did before, and you don't even have a sailcloth.
I would be fine.
Not Rue with it. Don't mind you. He'd be like, come on.
Thick stick.
Nice. Strike 3, you're out.
Okay. Now I need to cross the water. Aha! Ooh. Actually, I'm just gonna look over here for a second. I wanna see if there's anything behind the waterfall.
Fish. Hey, man.
Yep. Oh, I cannot get behind the waterfall.
Oh,
ancient Orawana. Orawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawawaw make fishing easier.
Blow up the fish.
Yes. What? Hey, it worked.
Too bad it doesn't cook them for you. That would be pretty
nice. Oh, you're gonna make yourself a little ship! Or a little raft, I guess.
Yep.
Look at that. It's like a hand. It looks like it could be a hammock. Mm-hmm. There, another one's just flying around. Look at that.
Yep.
I feel like that other one just spawned. Which I guess makes some sense because, you know, if something goes wrong, then you can make another one, but...
Mm-hmm.
Ah! You're going silent! God, I hope you're going in the right direction.
The shrine's right over there, see?
That's true. It just did not look like you were going to hit the, like, the docking area for a minute. It looked like you were going to go too... I guess there's crates over there. It'd be really awkward if you were just going to... It would be really awkward if you were just gonna
Oh, look, a burb.
Burb! Is it the bird of the word?
No.
Oh, okay. I'll save my singing for another time.
Yeah. Okay, so the glue lets things like the sail rotate still.
Nice.
I just need to climb up here and get to shrine. Because I want a new ability.
Yes, yes.
I want to see what other things I can do with my hand. Oh, I'm guessing it's bombs, because there's something explosive over there.
Oh, yeah. Make your hand explosive. That seems like a disaster waiting to happen, but at the same time, it also seems like fun. Oh, this is like in Twilight Princess, when you step back into the Temple of Time and you watch it reform itself around you.
Yeah.
That was so great. I loved the Temple of Time dungeon in Twilight Princess. There was something that was so nice and, like, kind of a quiet orderliness to it.
Yeah. Hi, Raru. Let's see what abilities I got now.
Oh.
Hey, Minnie, here. Now then, extend your right hand.
Hmm.
Oh, it's a sword.
Well, that's pretty.
Let's see what this is. Because I thought it was just going to be a simple bomb. But...
fuse. It is a fuse.
Attach something to an equipped weapon or shield to enhance it. You can undo the fusion, but that will destroy whatever has been attached.
To an equipped weapon.
This is the fuse ability. Allows you to fuse something nearby to your weapon or shield, thereby enhancing it. Why not pick up that sword just ahead and then fuse it with a nearby object?
There you go.
Using fuse and receive the blessing from the shrine.
This is going to be the thing that lets you make that giant spear.
Yes, it is.
You're going to be so happy. It's going to be like your magic spear.
Let's actually get rid of something. Doink. Oh, I think I know where this is going.
Lord, how did he not...
Can we just appreciate this fact for a second?
How did he not clobber himself with that? There's so many rocks falling. Stone is about as big as he is. No, if he curled up into a ball, he would be... Look at that.
The stone shrunk when I put it on my back.
Well, okay, so this is basically like the ball and chain or the iron boots. They just shrink in your inventory.
Ah.
Oh, cool. Chest.
Yeah, I saw it sitting around up there. Arrows. Oh, wait.
Oh, boy.
Oh. I can attach things to my arrows. I can't do it with environmental things, but I can choose things from my inventory. Ooh, what are these? Fire fruit, a fruit that generates heat when stuck. Cooked correctly, its heating properties improve blood flow and stimulate muscles to raise attack power in high temperatures.
Oh, very nice.
Oh, I think I know what I'm going to use this for.
The snowy area?
No. There's...
Oh, I see what you're going to do. You're going to set this on fire.
Yeah, rather than just having traditional fire arrows. Doink, doink, doink.
That's awesome.
Oh, I just thought of an interesting idea. What if... Ah!
You wanted to take the treasure chest, didn't you?
Yeah. Oh?
What can you do with that? Can you shoot with it? No, you
can't. No, it just makes it longer.
Just be whacking at people with the end of a bow.
I'm going to have so much fun of using this fuse ability. Oh my gosh.
No, oh my god, he is such a dork. I love him.
Oh, you little.
Smile. Okay, this enemy music is cool.
I'm gonna beat you up with my sword.
I'm gonna beat you up with my bow sword.
Construct bow.
Ooh.
Okay.
Ooh.
Captain Construct Bow, +5 fuse attack power. Don't need a charge. Rock hammer. And I'm gonna get rid of one of my bows so I can pick up the better bow. And Hey, I'll leave a few things unfused for now. I know that they showed this off in the trailers, but I tried to avoid spoilers, and I'm gonna say I'm gonna have so much fun with this. Oh.
I'm looking forward to when he's able to drive that car. It's gonna be really fun. Oh, nice.
Oh, plus 5 attack power. That is good.
Basically, just made yourself a mace. Spiky stick. Spiky stick. Does whatever a spiky stick does.
Oh, Kevin! Oh, guess it's not strong enough.
Bonk! requires more bonk power.
Oh, gosh. Oh, I am definitely, though, probably going to play my own profile while I'm exercising, but I do want to save this one for when we're together.
Yes, please. If you don't, I'm gonna be mad.
I will not. If I play through it more on my own, I will do an own profile and leave this one for us together, and okay. I will not spoil anything.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I am fascinated though, because that one does look like Princess Zelda, especially from yeah. the Princess. It looks more like the rock behind you. It looks more like your Twilight Princess design.
Yeah. You know, I imagine that when I get enough of these, I'll be able to increase either his health or stamina.
Yeah.
I wonder if doing that will cause some of the blackness to recede. Because that would be a really cool feature.
Yeah, you think about the runes on the markings on his chest and upper shoulder?
Yeah.
I wonder if that's there to... I'm not sure, because at first, before we knew that his arm was replaced...
Yeah.
We thought that it was there to help contain the curse that was on him.
Yeah.
But now that it's there, I'm wondering... Oh, hello.
Yeah.
Oh, he knows your name.
Yeah, but...
Wait, okay, hang on.
No, can I just say something real quick?
Sure.
But even though it might have replaced his arm, it's still, you know, like, giving off the dark energy, so it might still be wrong. I came because there's something I failed to give you. Please take it. What is that?
Energy cell.
A gift from Zodia Construct, designed to be worn on a belt. It can power Zonia devices. What I've just given you is an energy cell. It is required to make use of the tools known as Zonia devices. I cannot demonstrate this utility because there are no Zonia devices right here. However, I have an associate on the other side of the cave system. They can teach you how to use this. I hope that energy cell provides useful to you, or proves useful to you. Okay, yeah. So...
I wonder if that will be helpful with those Zonai, like the little light spheres that you've been collecting.
Maybe. Yeah, I might be able to use them, use them as like fuel.
Yeah. Catch!
Oh, all right, I forgot about shield surfing. Watch this, ready?
Yes.
Yeah. Not, I can't really use it right here, but I can use it to like get down slopes faster.
That was kind of my first, ooh, something shiny.
It's a rush room. Let's see what's down here first.
Ooh.
Oh, that's right, there was a breakable wall up near the shrine. Gotta go back up.
Oh,
what's this? Oh, rock.
I wonder if the markings are meant to contain the evil, or if they're actually something to help him support the arm.
Maybe. Yeah, that is a good question. Oh, it looks like there's actually a secret way underneath the lake. Oh, but there wouldn't be a way for me to get through it because I wouldn't have the fuse ability. Well, it looks like there's something over there.
That's a really cool shot. Have you ever been to Niagara Falls?
Yes.
Yeah, have you gone into caverns behind the falls? You
can
just, like...
Oh, no, I didn't go behind caverns. I didn't know there were caverns behind the falls.
Yeah, you can...
Wait, sorry, you weren't there. I thought that's like, wait, didn't we go together? I was like, no, my parents came up one time to Rochester, and then I think we went to visit the falls.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I think the one that we went to were behind the Canada Falls.
You could actually, there was like this whole tunnel system that was pretty cool. You know, they did little tours and sightseeing stuff there, but you could actually go to a section and stand there and you would just see this small opening that was just full of like the rushing water because it was right behind the falls.
Who put a chest back here?
Someone who did not want a dorky, excitable teenager to come get it.
Well, then they shouldn't have put it next to the shrine where you get to make, where you get to attach boulders to the sword.
I didn't say that it was a smart decision. Especially since, you know why? Especially since they only put 5 arrows in there.
Yes.
Like, what are you doing?
Oh, slimy guys!
Oh.
Chew jellies! Nice to see them actually fighting each other, though, instead of me. Yeah. Still, free stuff! Plus 1 fuse attack power.
Nice.
Oop.
I like, Link looks at long stick, Link jumps in the air.
Yeah. I'm actually going to get rid of this bow sword.
Bye-bye.
And I'm going to hold onto this long stick until I can find another long stick.
And make a really, really long stick?
Yes. I can now shoot. I love how you can shoot, like, apparently, like, almost anything at the enemy. Oop, that guy down there had the long stick.
Oh, yeah.
Also, I think that fusing things actually really increases their durability. Oh, he's using a fused thing, I think.
Yes.
Okay, so it's not a long stick.
So what is that all about? Do you have a long stick? No, you have a thick stick. That guy's stick is on fire!
Oh god, he's setting the grass on fire.
Ah, run away! Stop, drop, and roll! Actually, that is a question. Can Link do like a roll attack in this game?
No. Hold on, I'm just picking this up. Look at this thing.
Oh, a board guster that may. Perhaps that can help you, like, when you make your little sail.
Yeah, and apparently the weapons can also use fused items.
Yeah,
oh!
Yeah, see? Because the wind took you here, but you may need that to get off.
Yes, or to get back, but I think I am going in a big circle. But yes, I get what you mean. Okay, so what item can I drop?
Even shrinking this does not look good to the ground. The boulder arrow was one thing, but there's no way.
Extra long stick and plus 4 attack power. Oh, that's actually interesting because apparently, if you fuse 2 weapons, it might just like add the attack power to the other. Whereas with random objects, it might be a little bit less. Yeah. Radiant spear. Okay, what am I? I'll replace an axe with it.
Okay.
Unless. Oh, I can't. Oh, maybe that. Oh, you know what? That's it. The items that have like that blue outline around them, they are ones that cannot be fused with other things.
Good to know. All right, time to do some cooking.
Yep.
I love the look on Link's face. Okay. I love the look on Link's face when you put the stuff in his inventory. He's like, oh, okay, we're doing this now. All right.
Energizing skewer. Great for climbing walls.
Here, hold the fish, sweetheart. Hold the fish. You know, another reason to love that culinary construct so much, he clearly made his little cooking stations very fun to use. Look at them, they do little dances. Like, this is great.
Yep.
And
you can actually usually hear him humming a little bit to himself.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Alright, let's head to that cave system the robot mentions.
He is humming, that's so cute.
Oh. Wait, what am I? Oh, okay, yeah. Let's stick with this weapon for now.
Discovery!
Bright bloom seed. When stuck, it will take root and bloom, giving off faint light from a small flower. Oh, I bet I can, like, attach this to stuff to use as a torch.
Cool. Oh, hey, guys.
Eyeball!
Yay!
Wing! Ooh, yes.
What? Amber!
The Amber looks different than it did in the last game, which I guess makes sense. What the heck is that?
That is a ghostly frog. Hi, man. Oh!
Oh, what is that? Bugle gem, a strange crystal left by defeating Bugle frogs in caves. The eerie blue glow may entice you to collect even more.
Okay, that's a little creepy. I'm not gonna lie, that's a little creepy.
Yes, it is. Sorry, I'm switching back to this.
I thought you were going to use the board guster for a minute. Be like, here! Basically, giant fly swatter.
Yeah, definitely keep an eye out for more glowing frogs then, because something tells me that they will give me...
No, those creepy gems?
Yes, which might be used for something. Okay, whatever. I'll figure it out later. I'm just going to get the chest, go back for that wall, then come back this way.
Ooh,
hooray, I have a shirt! Oh, this is what it looked like in the beginning of the game.
Yeah. It's got some holes, but the soft cloth feels good to the touch. It's hard to keep it wrinkle-free. Well, especially if it only covers half of your body and hangs on you.
Giant bloom seed. Seed found on ground. Radiating a large amount of light from the big flower. Okay. More flints. Oh, this one looks like it's... This the shiny one will likely have gems in it. Yes, a ruby. Yeah.
Nice.
I guess it's Tuesday. It's Ruby Tuesday!
Lord, man.
We should definitely stream more tomorrow.
You know what that means?
What?
Link needs to eat something. Go do some more cooking. Alright.
Hmm, what's this? Oh.
Hi.
It looks like a fan, maybe. Rats crossing to the other side are broken. Transportation is on hold indefinitely. This is originally where we send resources across the river. Only silver lining is that the Zonia devices are damaged. Zonia devices. Ah, yes, it seems that you do not know about them. Your necessities around here. Allow me to explain. This green thing is called the Zonia device. The one you have here is a fan. You can produce wind on demand by striking it. They are self-evidently useful. We have a variety of Zonia devices for multitudinous purposes. Using Zonia devices does require energy. An external energy cell will be necessary in your case. Ah, you already have one. That is a relief. Perhaps a refresher explanation is in order. An energy cell stores the energy required to use Zonia devices. Its energy will replenish automatically while Zonia devices are not in use.
That's nice.
Its capacity is not unlimited. Use the energy contained within wisely, otherwise you may run out at inopportune moments. Pardon the long explanation. It does not change our need for a bath. Zonia devices are extremely useful in a creative way, and you will find many ways to employ them. Oh, there's like three of them around.
Hi.
That is a problem.
Are you a talented technician in a hurry?
Yeah. Okay, what's up?
Hi!
Sewer constructs were first built. After that, we crafted others suited for different roles. Culinary constructs, maker constructs, you will find all sorts of them still active in this place. Some become so skilled within their specialties that they surpassed us. And we get to learn from them instead. You should take time out to talk to them. They can teach you many things you may not yet know.
I'm just hanging out.
Oh my god, I can combine.
You want to stick the box on your... people already been used. That would be pretty funny.
I can't destroy the fused material. Dang.
And now without breaking stuff.
Yeah, all my weapons are already have fused, so.
It would be pretty funny if you just keep adding new things to it.
Wait, this one is almost broken, so I'm just gonna get rid of it anyway. But I now have a tree branch.
I'm going to stick the crate on your tree branch.
This is
Tears of the Kingdom.
Yes. I can even attach a pot to it. I think attaching a pot to the weapon would give Link some extra satisfaction given his love of breaking pots.
Yes. Okay,
before I construct the raft, actually I'm gonna head over here, because it looks like there is something. Yeah, there's like a few floating platforms over here, so. Probably use it to go up, but for now I'm gonna have it go down. Hmm? Why is it not letting me grab it? We'll figure it out later.
Yeet. Oh, hello.
Okay. So the things stuck to the weapon can break themselves. And one of my bows is about to be destroyed anyway, so I may as well get rid of it. Ooh, what's this?
A flower. Actually, it looks more like a leek.
Yeah, but it's apparently a stamina bulb.
Mm-hmm. Actually, just a stam bulb.
Stam bulb.
Stam bulb!
Oh, let's turn this around.
You can climb it. Treasure chest.
Sit here, does nothing.
It is open.
Amber. Now Link, get down. I am just having a lot of fun though, just playing around with all the powers. Even though it just started, these are really fun powers. I keep pushing the wrong buttons.
Da da da. Da
da da. Oh, a little too high.
Da, 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 da.
ending up here. Oh, there's a big tree stump.
Good start. Maybe you'll find a core up here.
That would actually be, that would actually make a lot of sense.
Oh. Quick, roast some apples.
Yep, Korok.
Ah! My god, wait a minute, how'd you not burn him?
He was under the rock.
I know, but still.
He's a magical tree plant guy.
And you just hit him with the rock. Stop hitting him with the rock.
No, it's tradition.
Why do I have to say this to you? Don't hit the adorable tree stumps with a rock. Oh lord, there is a sentence to be taken out of context. That makes... That's a very specific sentence to be had here.
Okay. Whee! Water, my lady, water.
That's probably why it's there. It's yes. Clearly to protect you.
Yes. All right, let's make a raft.
Look, guys, I'm in a raft.
Oh, action. I was facing it the wrong way, but...
Zone 9 motherboat.
Yes. Beautiful. And based on the structure of the little device I was given, my guess is that it will... I'll be able to get, like, more fuel cells for it later, so that way it can last longer.
Yeah.
Maybe that's what those charges will help.
Maybe. Turn on, turn off. Thank you for turning on lights. Yes, it was getting a little dark.
Just a little.
Yes. Okay. Hey, buddy, what's up?
Hi. Hey, how are you doing?
Let's hear them. Fire is a crucial tool in traveling mountain fire.
Cook or warm yourself.
That is my recipe for fire. This is basically Minecraft.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes. Let's pick this up.
I must protect myself. Oh.
Buddy, I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm just trying to break open this box.
Well, even still, he's probably not worried about you attacking him as he's worried about being collateral damage.
Okay. That's fair.
Aww.
Okay. Let's cook a few of these and see what happens. Oh, wait, that's right. Put that there. Okay, hot weather attack. Not what I was hoping for.
Yeah. It would have been a little amusing because those things have proven to be somewhat fiery / explosive. It would have been a little amusing if it burst in his face.
Why do I have so few hearts? Oh, must have been that other enemy.
Yeah, you got attacked. The one that you were fighting against with your crate stick.
Yes, that's right. I forgot about that. Let's make some. Let's cook some stamina bulbs.
Oh.
sweet and tasty.
I have a stick of fire!
I'll put it out for now, but just...
Oh. Hey, man.
Okay, yeah. So I can use it to recharge the battery.
Cool.
Oh! Hello.
Hi! Hey!
Yeah, hopefully I will be able to find something that lets me resist the cold easier than having to make a fire.
Yeah. Especially since you're wearing a shirt that only covers the half of your body.
Yeah. We'll see how it goes.
And you have a skirt that I do think is shorter than your underwear. Which is a little amusing. Choo-choo. It'd be really funny if you could attach a choo-choo jelly to a stick.
No, but you can attach it to the arrows. I know that much.
The really long arrow.
Yeah, well, choo-choo jelly can also take on different environmental forms. Okay, it's up there, so... Oh, it looks like I need a minecart.
Oh, yeah.
Not to be confused with a Yore cart. Oh.
We're basically gonna steve this place up.
Yeah.
And I'm not gonna drop it on your head this time. Oh, they're all so curious. What are they doing?
Oh!
Whoa!
It didn't hurt me, but it sent me flying.
Yeah. Sorry. The look of her just going flying in a little amusing. Yeet.
He isn't actually hurting me though, he's just knocking me around. There we go.
It looks like it's happy. It looks like it got happy.
Yeah. If this is like the last game, when I find Hetsu, he will let me increase my inventory spaces for Korok seeds as payment.
Cool.
What's inside?
Opal! It contains the power of water.
That actually means that it might have some use to actually attach it to an arrow rather than just...
What?
Well, then just sell it, because I was thinking, it's like, why on earth would you want to attach something that's worth a lot of rupees to an arrow?
Oh, mining cave! Okay, here we go. This is gonna be fun! All right, let's go. Here, hold on tight, but hit me with a block sword.
Oh. It's dark.
Whoa. Oh. Back.
Okay. Oh, actually, hold on. Now, do I have a... Yes. Where there's the... Okay. No, no. Oh, and then I can pick up the tree branch again. And that's how I can use that to get my way through dark caves. Very nice.
Hi.
This cave is especially dark. You will need light in order to proceed in the mining area. Do you have any bright bloom seeds? Glowing flowers are bright blooms. They shine very brightly and it uses illumination in dark places. These bright blooms grow natively in caves such as this one. Caves have been picked mostly clean of them. This is because it's especially dark. The seeds were often necessary. I'm supposed to provide a reminder to bring bright bloom seeds. By the way, did you know bright blooms require a stimulus to blossom? Striking a seed or attaching it to an arrow will cause it to activate on impact. The bright bloom you see here, well, there is no different. Okay, good to know.
Thanks, man.
Okay, but I cannot combine them with weapons once they are planted. Oh, that one's like glowing bluish. Oh, I bet it has the glowing stone in it.
Yeah,
oh, maybe not. Usual material with many purposes. Ancients extracted energy from it and refined it for crafting weapons and armor. Oh, that must be why it has its own little counter up there.
Oh, cool.
So I definitely gotta keep a hold of that.
I wonder if those things, those zonites will... let you have some of the... Maybe it can help you get some of the energy charges?
Maybe.
Or make some stronger weapons for yourself. Or if maybe you're able to kind of distill them into both, you know?
Yeah, or maybe even make like some Zodiite armor.
Yeah. Oh, what was the shiny thing over there?
What shiny thing?
That was just your stick. I didn't see them sparkle before, so I was like, oh wait, something shiny! Oh wait, it's a stick.
Yeah.
I don't see you pick up your bow, but boy do I get distracted by a shiny stick. You realize I'm basically a cat.
Hey, that's okay. Most of Doug Doug's audience is supposedly a cat.
Hi.
Excuse me. That zoning is already slated for processing. It would pose difficulties for me if you took it for yourself. Processing? Oh, you're not familiar with it?
In the land below?
Yeah. There are trace deposits of it here on the island as well, but they are limited to this cave. Okay. Processing. By smelting it in a furnace, it is thereby converted into materials with useful properties. A few such materials will be ready for your review shortly. Wait a moment. Okay. I do kind of love the, like, way it kind of, like, helps teach this.
Yeah. Thank you for your patience.
Yeah. Zonite technology is powered zonite charges. These occasionally solidify into a form known as crystallized charges. Converting zonite into other useful materials this way is called processing. Charges. Power with zonite devices as constructs. Charges can be constructed to replenish your energy cell. Crystallize.
Construction of energy cells.
Oh.
So you're...
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so I can trade,
Oh, see. You know what you're doing is that he's processing the stuff for you, and you can take the, finish requirement, and then you're giving him the zonite to...
Yeah.
I thought it was fascinating how he said that they were that they are found plentiful on the land below. There's only a few traces of it in the cave. Like, it's kind of...
going back to the castle in the sky thing, it's kind of like Ethereum.
Yeah. Yep.
I wonder why it's not so calm in here. Your behavior's... Oh, I'm sorry, buddy.
Sorry, I was just trying to break that. What are these? I have not given permission to take those.
Sorry.
Could it be that you have forgotten to bring Zoni eye capsules?
Ooh, oh, cool.
Convenient means of carrying portable Zonia devices.
I will lend you a few space. Oh, thank you. Generate wind struck.
Okay, so...
I keep watch for such individuals.
Okay, so I can actually put, or I can actually have the devices, like, stored in my inventory and then use them whenever. That's actually really kind of cool, though. Oh my god.
Oh no. Are you fusing the mine card to your
weapon? Oh, what? Okay, let's destroy one of the fusions then.
I think it will destroy both.
No, it'll destroy one of the items. What? No. It only increases the attack by one, but I just wanted to see if I could do it.
Mine card hammer. Whack! Oh my god. Can you just imagine what anybody would see if they once like run around with a minecart attached to a stick? Be like, okay, look, kid, I knew that you were wacky, but I didn't think you were this wacky. What nope. Are you doing?
Okay, I'm just gonna quickly check on top of this building to see if there's anything up there.
Come on, buddy, you can get that. There you go.
Okay. And... no. But, you know, never hurts to check.
Can you climb up this, like, roofing? Oh, it's just shoes to the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
Yeet! My car hammer!
To move the cart up a bit first.
Alright, now hit the minecart with the minecart. Charge! Look at his hair blowing in the wind. Look at Tarzan's hand.
Yeah. Oh, there's where I just was, but now I'm moving on by. Okay, and there's the places that are closed.
Hey, Ramu! Check out what I did!
I'm sure he's very amused. The time bell that sounds from the Temple of Time rings at set times each morning and evening. Along with the constructs, we awoke to the sound of the bell. We heard it in the evening, we knew it was time to rest. We also played its parts in our traditional ceremonies. In a way, it was this place's beating heart. The sound of the temple and the sound of its bell stir fond memories. Oh, what on earth? I'm guessing this is where I can get more of those little devices.
Oh, that's cool. It's like a bingo machine. What's he use this device? Oh,
resources except are things such as construct, horns, and zodiac charges. Okay.
Honey, I think this is about the fifth different way you pronounce Zonai.
I don't know how to pronounce that. Zonai!
Zelda said it out loud. You said Zonia, you said Zonian, you just said Zodiac. I don't know.
Zodiac!
What are you doing? This is like Hylia versus Hyrule all over again. Oh, Lord Child, what is this?
Really?
Oh, I got a lot of them.
Whoa. Flame emitter. Cool. Fire. Portable pot. I feel like you just got a bunch of capsules from Mario Party.
Let's get more.
Either that or you played a really good round of bingo.
Yep.
Oh my god, he's so happy!
Actually...
I need to- oh!
Oh, okay, hold on, hold on. I need to get one of the Zodiac capsules.
Zonai capsule.
Zonai.
Not, not Zodiac. There is no D or C in this word.
No, I don't want it on the mine. Oh. Guess what my shield can do now.
Oh, that's awesome. My gosh.
I saw it. I remember seeing it in a trailer, but now my shield can shoot flamethrowers. Oh, I'm going to need my minecart, I think. It's like a full-on evil tower over there.
Oh, evil tower in this garden of time. That sounds dangerous. Oh yeah, I see what you mean though.
Okay, hey buddy. Yep.
There he is. Hang on, buddy. Hop in.
Oh, that's good. Oh, I can't lift it with him in it, so. Okay, buddy, just gonna put you there for a second. And climb in. Grab you.
Come on over. Hit my minecart
with my minecart, and away we go. Arr! It's
alright, buddy. Hang on. Oh, my minecart is rolling away. Yeah, it's a slight incline. There you go. Come on, buddy. There's my friend. You're here! Aww. Okay, that's adorable.
Yeah, and I do kind of like this little quest you have with them. Okay, let's see what's in here. Nice.
She's not sure if she, like, Zelda's in the temple of time and she's able to see where you are. She just sees Link running around, like, attaching minecarts to a stick and, you know, putting a flamethrower on his shield and dropping Koroks into carts and just having a good time.
Yeah.
She's probably like, okay, look, I'm glad you're not dead, but what are you doing?
If she's able to watch Link, she is used to this kind of nonsense from him, given all the nonsense he pulled. While she was waiting, while she was trying to hold back Calamity Ganon for a while.
Oh lord. Really, Link is just a complete and total goofball.
Mm-hmm.
I think... Oh god. Who's... Okay, here's a... Oh, danger.
What if... Okay, hold on. Yes, maybe I can. Ah, no, I can't. Can't get high enough. Oh, that can't get high enough. Just gotta put some stuff on top of it.
Give yourself a little bit of a boost?
No. I don't think it was enough, because I also don't think it's not long enough, so. Oh, maybe that'll work.
You didn't make it up, borrow your stick? Or actually, no, you got the hook. This is even better.
I don't think it's really gonna work. I'm gonna head back over to the other side. Just don't think I have the tools necessary to fix the broken part yet.
Since you're not working with that for a little bit, I have a question for you. Who is a bigger goofball, Toon Link or Breath of the Wild?
Question. Breath of the Wild Link does know how to take things very seriously.
Mm-hmm. So does Toon Link.
Yeah. But I honestly do not know.
Remember the look on his face when he saw the kit, when he saw the Helmarok King, and he's like, no.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Oh. They both have excited hopping animations.
I don't think I can actually get over there yet, even with this platform. Can I?
I think you can. It looks like you can.
Okay. Then let me just actually save.
Okay, we haven't saved yet.
I'm pretty sure it's been auto-saving.
Yeah, I think it has. I've seen that logo in the corner. Yep. Save, just in case you die.
Oop, wrong button.
Yeah, you're fine. You got this. Beamos! Whoa! Flux construct. Oh my gosh!
Oh gosh! I think I might be here a little early.
This is kind of like a warm cube. Look at this!
I've got it!
Yes! Woohoo! First boss fight! Done!
Ooh. Even dropped a few fans. What on earth?
That's a hello. I think it looked like Link winced there for a minute when he was standing on it.
Yep.
Wonder if you can.
Actually, I'm gonna destroy this one. No.
Nice!
Just
made yourself a
zonai mace. Yeah. There's anything really here save for the boss, but still, that was fun. Mm-hmm. I can get a little look at where I'm going. still don't really have a way to get through without setting like a weapon or something on fire. Yeah, we'll work it out.
Yeah, I just realized something. No. Oh God.
I'm fine. Even if I fall, I'm not gonna die.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure.
God, how embarrassed would you be if you were wrong?
I'd be more just like facepalm.
Nope, I am not. Yeah, you would definitely
facepalm. Oh, thank goodness.
Audible. Ooh.
Spicy peppers. These I can cook to give me cold resistance.
Awesome. Okay. Hi. Warm sounding names.
Yeah. Ingredients and cooking are the main way that you get through certain areas with either heat or cool before you find the correct clothing that will give you similar abilities.
Yeah. Alright, so this Link hums and shears when he cooks. And Toon Link meows like a cat when he's spotted.
Yeah. Okay. And I'll cook three different dishes, each of varying times. And I will start with the 12-minute one, and then I'll have the 7-minute one as a backup.
Alright. Okay. Chat, anybody who's listening, vote on who, say who you think is goofier, Toon Link or this Link. I am not sure.
Nope. Go down, Link. Okay, let's see where this goes. Okay, it does lead to more chili peppers, which is good. If worst comes to worst, I can put down one of the pots. Okay, so that's a way out, possibly into the cold, but also likely closer to the
into the unknown. Mm-hmm. Into the glowy frog. Whoa.
I think those are references to an enemy from the original game that if you shot, you would get rupees.
Okay.
They look like little blue bunnies.
Back.
Okay, just a short shortcut back. I think I have enough stamina to get up there. Jumping is faster, but it actually uses up stamina faster than if you just climb normally.
So it's not an equal trade-off.
Nah. Good for going places fast, not good for...
going places steadily.
Or for making it up, like, long cliffs. Yep, temp.
Oh! Look at it! Oh yeah. My god. There you go.
Oh, gotta get it before it freezes. Yeah, if I leave food out in the cold, it will actually freeze. Oh, careful. Yeah.
Ooh.
Could be used as the equivalent of ice arrow. There's a flower up there. And the cold music starts playing.
Yeah.
more accurate than I thought. There you go, you got it.
Yep, gotta catch it.
I
figured there would be something like that. I'm glad I held on to this board, though.
This board. Oh my god, this board.
Oh, I see another puzzle over here. Now it's actually started heading up towards the shrine.
Hey, bro.
No.
No. No. You're gonna throw it at him.
Only doing their duty to protect the Garden of Time. At a time, it was sadly necessary to protect our lands from invaders. I'm terribly sorry any threat they pose to you now. Oh, that was a tree branch. Okay. Huh? Oh.
Oh, hey guys. How's it going?
There's a fire pit over there that I can use later if I need it. For now, I'm just gonna keep moving forward and see if I can find a way up that I see.
A chicken! Oh, wait, is that a chicken?
No, it's a bird.
Well, chicken is a bird.
It's not a chicken bird, it's a bird bird.
It's not a chicken bird, it's a bird bird. Bird bird is the word, and word the bird bird bird, but the bird is the word.
Oh, let's let these guys actually fight it out. Red shoe jelly from the fire.
Whoa, that's cool.
Bomb fruits? Yep, see, there's the little rupee guy.
Yeah.
But that's weird. There weren't actually bomb fruit or bomb flowers in Breath of the Wild. You only had the remote bombs. Mm. Do not mix well with fire and electricity unless the goal is to blow things up.
It could be. You're just hoping that the thing that you're blowing up is not you.
Yes. Wrong button.
Like, throw a stick. You. No.
I just realized with bomb flowers, it means that I can now have bomb arrows. Also, how nice that these bomb flowers do not explode the moment you pick them up, or do not start to explode the moment you pick them up. So you can actually carry them around with you.
That's fair. thinking about an Ocarina of Time and Wind Waker.
Yep.
Pick it up. So you're just like, oh no, stop, stop. Hey buddy, catch. Oh my god.
I wonder if this is the equivalent of a like-like.
Something like that. It also reminds me there were certain enemies from Pillar Princess and the Forest Temple that were kind of like that.
Yeah. Okay, let's do something a little bit faster. There we go.
Psychic up.
Nope, Link, change weapons.
Does whatever the spiky club 2 does.
Like stuff.
Oh, you're right.
Made of crystallized inner fluids. Ew. It's a good ingredient in elixirs. It ate a treasure chest.
Well, I mean, clearly was hungry. It was happy to eat treasure chests, you, and bombs.
Very cool.
He doesn't even stand it up right. He just is like, oh, this is fine. I'll just open it sideways. Oh. Nice.
Okay, cold resistance is running a little low. Or not low, but you know.
Yeah, you're about halfway through.
Yeah.
If you eat another food that's like would give you cold resistance, do they stack on top of each other?
Or? I believe so.
Cool.
I can't remember honestly though. So if I'm wrong, I apologize. And I'll try to get over there later. Oh, let me guess, I can't climb up this. Got it. No.
It was a good try.
No.
Okay, that was slightly less than perfect.
That's okay. I know what I have to do. I just need to do it like this. No, Link. Link.
Come on, buddy. You got this. You can do this. There you go. Good job.
Da 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 da
He's so excited. Oh my god.
Oh, and there's something up there that I can get to. Now I have plenty of time now, so let's see if I can pick up this guy.
There you go.
Oh, wait.
Oh, careful.
Yeah.
There you go. Yes. Okay, there you go. He's got it.
Oh, there's a nice little thing over there.
Oh, little
treasure. Arctic, yes!
Yay!
That means I don't need the, I don't need the cold resistance anymore, because now I can walk around without it.
Yay!
And I can go exploring over there later. If you ever see anything weird, assume it's a Korok being a Korok.
That's fair. This is actually reminding me of the in Ocarina of Time circles like that. I think if you played the Song of Storms or Zelda's Lullaby, it would open up a little hole.
Oh, I didn't actually know that. Oh my god, that makes so much sense. I had wondered, it's like why there were circles of stones and stuff, and like how to get in there. I never realized you needed the song.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I think it's the Song of Storms.
Yep.
Oh. Hi. Look at this hair. Look at this fabulous hair right here.
Oh. These are the things in one of the trailers that Link was gliding on.
Oh, that's awesome.
It doesn't look like they work at the moment.
And in Majora's Mask, the guy who has the stone mask, I know his name, Shiro, he has, he's sitting in one of those. It's a clue.
Yeah. Well, in the original, he is. In later, in the remake, he is in the middle of the Gerudo Fortress.
True.
Which makes it kind of, I think, more hilarious, because it's like he is so unnoticeable that all these women pirates that do not like men cannot see him.
Well, he is wearing the stone mask for at least some of it.
That's fair, yeah. But even when he like runs out, he still can't, like, you know. They still can't see him.
And not only that too, but some of the ladies who have are not fooled by the mask, meaning that he probably could have just been spotted anyways. That they probably didn't care.
Yeah.
They didn't notice or didn't care that much because he clearly wasn't doing anything.
Yes, and he was clearly injured.
Which was also a little funny because they are totally fine with this small... Because they do not have much of a problem with this... No, they do have a problem with this small child running in and doing things. Granted, the small child is better armed, which is a little funny if you think about it.
Yes.
But still, it's like small child versus armored Ooh!
Harnesses that can harness lift to ride the wind. Fly
oh.
fast.
Oh! That's probably for those gliders.
Yeah, but I'll figure out how they work later. I need to go to the shrine now.
Woohoo!
Oh, actually, but first I'm gonna get more items just in case there are more gliders in here. I love that. Just
like those things at the museum that you can ride in and just watch it spin around.
Yep. Yep, there are a few winged things here. Oh, here we go. This one is actually glowing.
Oh.
Okay. Hmm.
Like he's trying to strike a giant match. Whack!
Maybe he doesn't have the ability to use this yet. I can move it around, but... Okay, it says it needs a lift, so it could be that whatever ability I get up in the shrine up here is lift. Is like some sort of, you know, like lift ability or like some sort of wind.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Here we go to the shiny thing.
Rock of Doom.
Well, no, not the Rock of Doom. The Rock of Anti-Doom. This is supposed to cleanse you of evil. There's...
Okay, you're right.
The Doom is not...
Rock of Anti-Doom, go!
And Rock of Anti-Doom. Don't mind me holding this giant, like, rock mallet here. I'm just going to,
Yeah, I should probably change that weapon. Actually, no, I can keep it. Do-do-do-do-do.
Let's see what he gets. Floating. Look at his fluffy boots. I love it.
Yeah.
Oh. Hey.
Ah.
Well, I think it's fascinating if Raru has no physical form anymore. And it sounds like something about the way he was saying makes it sound like he hasn't had a physical form for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
How was he able to give Link his arm?
Well, the arm was solid. It was what was holding it. Oh, move upwards through solid materials and emerge at the top of it.
There. Oh.
This is the ascend ability. Let you travel through what's directly above you to ascend through it and emerge on top of it.
That sounds like a really good climbing.
You'll find it quite useful for all sorts of places and situations. Use ascend and retrieve the blessing. Retrieve the blessing. Blah, 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 blah.
English.
English.
English. Of course, they put it at the top of the... Oh! Oh, God. Yeah, I guess that would be a little disorienting.
Just over on that one though, so yeet.
That's right. Well, they have it there.
Yep. Stone axe.
Okay, that is really cool and also a little creepy.
But it is something that they showed in the trailer, so.
That's true. It's. It's not like a teleporter, you know, like, just be careful when you teleport into, like, solid rock stuff, like.
Oh, I see. Just give me a second, I'm gonna look around a little. Oh, I also see. Let's get something actually sharp, or fiery.
Yep, one.
Link.
Fire, please. There we go, two.
That also helps. Okay, but I can also head up here. This ability is so cool.
It's really cool.
It's weird, but cool. Also, I do love the fact that it actually also lets you drop items directly from the chest. Because in the other game, you normally had to just leave it in the chest, go into your inventory, select something, and then get rid of it.
He looks so disoriented when he pops out.
Yeah. Oh, I wonder if this... Okay. Come on, buddy. Dives face first into stone.
I know. I feel like this is just one that just feels like, oh god, it'd be so easy for this to go wrong and for him to knock himself out and get trapped or something.
Mm-hmm. Mind if I skip this part? Or do you want to watch the...
I'd like to watch it.
Okay.
Just...
Dum, dum. Now let's head back over to those glider things to see if I can get them to work so I can get down from here.
Unless it's going to teach me how to fast travel.
Hey, buddy.
So you restored some power to that new arm. Mm. Door to Temple Time should now open for you.
Thank you. There's a little breath misting in the breeze.
Okay, so it doesn't let me fast travel yet. Now that I can do this.
Oh, cool. You can see it moving. That was cool. We hadn't seen that before.
Yeah. And it also means I can probably get on top of like things like this tree easier next time. Okay, let's see if I can figure out how the heck these work.
What was the new device that you got? The new Zonai device?
It was one of these.
Can you attach your fan to it?
It seems like it's supposed to be able to do it without the fan. Oh, there we go.
Hang on! Woohoo!
There we go. I just needed to push it off the cliff.
Well, you know, how else are we gonna fly? Whee!
This is actually really cool.
That is awesome. That's terrifying, but it's awesome. If he had, like, mag boots or something, I'd feel better about it.
And sploosh.
Another happy landing.
Still, that was fun.
That was really cool.
Ooh, there's eggs up there. I want my omelet. Doesn't look like there's much else in here, save for some fishies. And they now crashed.
Bird.
Paraglider thingy.
Yeah, par.
Or not paraglider, I still need to get my paraglider.
Parabird.
Oh, hello. Find ourselves in a sea of clouds. Interesting. That would mean we're at quite an altitude. As you heard from the steward construct, this is a land. This land is the Garden of Time, head of the kingdom's rites and ceremonies. Mm. Though in my day, it was on the surface.
Oh, yep, he definitely. If he's not Rauru from Ocarina of Time, I'm gonna be incredibly surprised. I'd also be mad because I feel like it would be really cool if they did, you know, explore some of like the ancient past stuff. And hey, since this is these games are supposed to be out of time so far down the timeline that the split doesn't matter, what better game to revisit than the one that caused the split in the first place?
Yeah.
Because two small children were not properly educated, and what on earth could happen if you play it with Round with Time?
Well, hey, even if Link didn't end up successfully defeating Ganon, there's an entire other timeline for that, and people have theorized that this is that particular timeline, given how all the games in that Link's hat has a yellow rim on it, and that's also true of the of Link's champion's gear that you get for completing all 120 shrines in Breath of the Wild. So people think that this one is meant to be a hero defeated timeline originally.
It is also a little fascinating too that Ocarina of Time is the only one that creates a new timeline if Link is defeated.
Yeah.
I wonder why that doesn't happen in any of the other games.
I don't know either.
complete.
I see a giant glowing golden...
It's your thing. That's the thing that saved Zelda.
Yeah, all tiny one did, but this one looks a bit damaged. Or no, no, it doesn't.
It's a little chipped.
Yeah. Maybe. Let's see.
Hey.
I'm still dripping water.
Yeah, he is. Oh, yeah. Shiny yin yang tear thing? I'm gonna go touch it. What else are you gonna do, right? Whoa.
Zelda? What's going on?
She looks a little bit like Hylia. Hi.
What if I can't touch her because my hand is still corrupted?
Oh no.
I have such a bad feeling about this.
No, it's okay. It makes some sense. I mean, your arm has been cleansed. You've been able to open up the temple of time, which is a holy place.
Oh, she's giving...
Is she purifying the rest of you? Yeah, look at that.
I don't know, maybe... I don't know what's happening.
Is she giving you another power?
Maybe.
No, wait, don't come back. Wait, what happened?
I don't know.
Don't have to come back.
I'm still dripping water.
Yes. Recall.
Reverse an object's momentum until it goes back to where it was. You can stop the reverse momentum at any time.
Oh, that's so cool. Hey, how's it going there, buddy?
Recall. The ability to reverse the momentum of an object through time.
Oh.
Which I can use to get up there. Zelda has vanished as well.
Dizzy.
It is a song. It's a mystery to even me. Perhaps with some sort of echo, one that reflects her sheer will.
She was that determined to stay and help.
Now that you've been given this ability, no doubt it will prove important.
I'm Princess Zelda. Some phantasmal floating version of her. Yeah, that's accurate.
I wonder if this is actually going to be a dungeon.
Ooh, dungeon. Oh, that's fascinating. Oh, this is so cool. I'm not surprised that she gave you a new ability.
A statue! This lets you spend usually spirit orbs and such to increase health or stamina.
Yay! The goddess statue smiles on you.
Ooh, or maybe not yet. Maybe I need a fourth one. Okay, I probably need a fourth one.
Okay. It's letting you pray. Link jumps in front of the door instead of opening it. See now how to... Overall vitality. Hi!
Okay. You remain in a weakened state. You're not yet strong enough to open it. But there is one more shrine on the island. There you can get another blessing. You could have told me that before! Oh. If you add that to the other blessings you receive at shrines and offer them to the goddess, you might just find a way forward after all.
Aww.
What is... Let me see the pad.
To travel to certain places instantly. Oh, there we go. Now you can fast travel.
Oh, I know what's happening. There is a shrine, but it's back on the island where I started because there were those rotating gears right near the first teleporter pad.
Yeah.
Okay, teleportation animation is the same. Good to know.
Whee! Cutting grass. Wildlife taking shelter in the grass will sometimes jump out at you when you cut down their hiding place.
Yep, see? I'm back here, and there are these rotating platforms over here.
Oh, now we can reverse them and climb.
Yes.
You can, once you...
Uh-oh.
Rewind! Okay.
I'm glad to see it restore. It restores itself almost instantly.
Yeah, that's
nice. Aha.
Awesome.
Yeah. What's up, Daddy?
Hi.
This is the crystal refinery.
Ooh, energy wells.
Energy wells? Can increase the capacity of the energy cells you're carrying.
Aha!
This increased capacity will allow you to use the devices for longer periods.
Oh!
Check the distant depth of the world below. That is the origin source.
Alright, well then.
Okay, I'm just gonna see what's out here first before I go over there. Oh, look, more gliders.
Rock of anti-doom number 4.
Okay, and once we get through this, before I go back to the temple, I'm probably gonna save and end, because it is getting a bit late.
What time is it?
9:15.
Yeah, that'll do it. Yeah. Piemaster is unfortunately not one of those people who can call off work to play this game.
Nah.
Which is apparently what the... What'd you say? Was it on NPR or the radio or something?
Yeah, NPR, that people were taking the day off so they could play Breath of the Wild or...
Tears of the Kingdom.
Yeah, yeah. Oh. Well, this actually makes sense because it's, you know, it's a continuation of the ability I have.
Yeah.
Though it looks like the stuff that gets rewinds faster, potentially, than it moves.
I think you're right.
Yeah, see, it moves a bit slower than it actually rewinds.
A little bit.
Wait a minute. No way. No actual way.
Yes. Oh! Okay, that is really awesome. These arm abilities are pretty sweet.
Yes. Don't get me wrong, I love the abilities in Breath of the Wild, but these ones are just so much cooler.
Yeah. It's unfortunate the poor thing had to lose his actual arm in order to get the power up, though. Like
that. Yeah, and the Master Sword. Don't forget, the Master Sword was literally destroyed. Oh, I get what I gotta do. I need to hit it when they are aligned.
There you go. Good thing these things can't teleport you out when you're done. That puzzle would be a real pain to solve from the back.
Yeah.
That which imprisons and purifies each evil.
Yep, this light that will cleanse you of evil.
Hey. Ah. Wonder how different this arm feels for him. Just, obviously the abilities are different, but yeah. I wonder if it hurts. I wonder if it feels like longer or...
Yeah. I just thought of something. Imagine if I could attach a box to the end of the Master Sword.
For the love of God. Master Box. master box.
Yeah, well, I'm probably going to have to reforge the sword, considering that I literally broke it.
Well, you didn't break it.
I didn't. Like, Ganon broke it, but still.
Yeah. Ganon fleshed him out. I'm just going to... I'd say call him... I'm going to call him Ganon, that creature Ganon.
For now.
Because Ganon is a kind of a rebirth of the curse of Demise. So in a sense, the two are connected. And Demise has shown up once, whereas Ganon has shown up several times, and his legacy keeps continuing.
Yeah.
Plus, the way that he looked, is he looked more like Ganondorf than
Okay, Demise. Let's save.
Wow. All right.
And we will...
Excuse me. We shall burp our way into the closing monologue, everybody.
Yes, thank you everyone for watching. Thank you CyberX02 for following a few hours ago before we started the stream.
Oh, thank you, Cyber. Sorry, welcome to, and also, bye-bye.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, and I hope everyone had fun with that. We will definitely be streaming this quite a bit in the future.
Yes,
and... Well, that's all I have to say for now. I hope that we'll see you all next time and that you enjoyed the stream.
I hope that you all are enjoying watching this unfold, because I think this is actually one of the first games that we're streaming through that neither one of us has experience playing.
Yes.
Yeah, so we're excited to take you on this journey with us, Chet.
Yes, thank you, and good night, my Pie Disciples.
Good night, Internet.
Good night, my Pie Disciples.